Good morning. Today we will see how to implement the linear regression model in R. So we import the data set. The data set is on the desktop of my system and the data set name is the vehicle data set. So we import it into R Studio. So this data set has 1624 observation, that is data points, and it has 7 variable, that it has 7 columns. Okay, so we'll see the summary of this data set called vehicle. So it has 7 variables, started from vehicle to states, and these are the range or the scales of each variable. So whenever we have the variables having range of values or scales, then it is better idea to normalize this variable, so to ensure that the one variable do not overshadow the other variable. Okay, so we'll see the first 6 rows of this dataset vehicle. So these are the first 6 rows. Okay, so we are basically interested in these 3 variables from this data set, that is mileage, labor hour and labor cost. So given the mileage and the labor hours, we want to predict what would be the labor cost. Okay, so in machine learning we first pre-process the data set. In pre-processing we split the data set into 2 splits, that is one is train data set and other is the test data set. So the train data set will be used to build the machine learning model and test data set will be used to evaluate the machine learning model. So here I have used the sample function to split the data set into train and test. So the first argument indicates that the number of split, the second argument is the name of your data set, the third argument which is called replace and it is set to true, which ensures that there won't be any duplicate element into the train and test data set. The last argument probability, which gives you the percentage of split. So here we have defined the percentage of split to be 80-20. So 80% of instances will be copied into train and remaining 20% will be for test data set. So after splitting the data set, the next task is to copy the data, copy the splits into corresponding data set. So first we'll run this line. Okay, then we'll copy the first split which has the 80% of instances into train data. Okay, and the remaining split which has the 20% of instances into test data object. Okay, fine. After this we'll build the linear regression model by using the function called lm, and the formula that we have passed to this model is LC, as we want to calculate the labor cost and we are calculating this labor cost using 2 variables called mileage and LH. So these 2 variables are used to calculate the labor cost, and the data set that we have passed is train data set, because as we have seen in the beginning, that is we want to build the machine learning model using train data set. I'll just run this line. Okay, so your model, your linear model is built and now it is stored into this data object called result. We'll plot the linear model. Okay, so just click on cursor. So this is the linear model. This is the best fitted linear model which is created by using least square error method. So what is the least square error method? That is, every time you change your linear decision boundary, our objective is to reduce the mean square error. So we'll go on iterating, we are go on changing the position of line until the line will be best fitted to the instances on our input instance space. So that is the least square error method. So least square error method, it will always focus on keeping the mean square error minimum for the given linear regression line. So that's why this is the graph which indicates residuals versus fitted. We can have other type of graph also. So this is the graph which is between the standardized residuals and normal quantile values. So what is the quantile values? So we have seen in the summary of this data set, these are the normalized value. So as I told you, whenever there is a range of values for any variables, then it is better idea to normalize that variable. So this is the normalized versus standard residual graph. Again, we can have the scale location graph. So this is the scale location graph. And finally, we have the residuals versus leverage graph. So this is my linear regression line, and these points, they are best fitted to this linear regression while, where these are called as the Cook's line. Okay, well, we'll go to the next point. We'll see next line of code, that is, we'll see the summary of this linear model. Okay, so this is the summary of this linear model. We have used the formula called labor count, which is calculated as mileage plus labor hours. Okay, so these are the residuals for this linear model. So minimum value is 689.81. This is the first quantile, this is median, this is third quantile, and this is the maximum value. Okay, now we'll see the summary will also shows you the coefficients of your linear regression model. So we know that the linear regression model is represented as y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 into x, where y is your dependent variable, your response variable. Beta 0 and beta 1, they are the coefficients of your linear regression line, where beta 0, it represents the intercept of your linear regression line across the y-axis. Beta 1 is basically the slope of your linear regression line, and x is your independent variable. You can call it as your predictor or regressor. Okay, so here the coefficient, the intercept, that is beta 0 value for the linear regression line is 1.71, where this is the beta 1, which is 5.68, and this is beta 2, which is 7.41. Okay, because we have used the two variable to construct the linear regression model, thus we can call this linear regression line as the multiple linear regression, because we have used the multiple variables. In simple linear regression, we use only single variable. Okay, now this line, this bold line, it indicates the significance level of the each variable. Okay, and here we can find out that the three asterisk symbols means the variable has the confidence level of 99.99%, and it degrades as the variable has two asterisk, single asterisk. The variable which do not have any asterisk symbol, it means that its significance level is zero. The contribution of that variable in building the machine learning model is zero. So here you can find that the mileage variable, it do not have any significance level code, but the labor hours variable has the significance code level 3, which means that the labor hour variable has the major contribution in building the linear regression model. These are the other statistics like residual standard error, then multiple R-square and the adjusted R-square. So this multiple R-square and the adjusted R-square values, it defines the minimum variance of your dependent variable explained by the model. Okay, so this values, it indicates the model's explanation about the variance of your dependent variable. And these are some other measures, that is F statistics and P statistics and T statistics. Okay, fine. We'll go further and we'll see what would be the prediction of our model for the test data set. Okay, we can also see the coefficients of this results by using some other commands. So these are the other ways to find out the coefficient of your linear regression model. So this will be your intercept, that is beta 0, this is mileage, which is your beta 1, and this is labor hour, which is beta 2. So here mileage do not have any confidence in building the machine learning model. Now we'll predict the test data set result by using our linear model, which is constructed on train data set. So we'll just run this line, okay, and we'll see what would be the prediction. Okay, so this is the prediction for the first 6 variables by our model on the test data set. Now this is the prediction of labor cost by our model for the first 6 instances. Let's see what would be the actual data for this first 6 instances. Okay, now this is the instance number 2, that is vehicle number 2. The labor hour for this instance is 2.4, and the labor, the actual value of labor cost is $233.03. Okay, but our model has predicted the labor cost for this instance as $176.24. Okay, similarly for the second data, the actual value of the labor cost is $44.43, whereas our model has predicted it as a $50.20. Okay, so in the this is how we can construct the linear regression model by using the train data set, and we have predicted our linear regression model, which is built using train data set, on the test data set, which to evaluate its performance. And here you can find out our model, it gives the mixed results for the test data set, because for the first instance the error is very large, because the actual cost is $233, whereas the predicted labor cost is $176. Whereas for the second instance, the error is very minimum. The actual labor cost is $44.43, whereas the predicted cost for the second instance, that is 10th instance, for the 10th vehicle by our model is $50.20. So this is how we can implement the linear regression model in R. In the next video, we are going to see how to find the error and plot the error. We will also try to find out the mean square error, and then we'll try to plot the mean square error for the train data set as well as for the test data set. Thank you. We'll see the plot the graph for train MSE and test MSE in the next video. Thank you.